29. Can I just ask members to be conscious of the time allocated? Deputy Micheál Martin, please.
Thank you, Kian Corla. Taoiseach, I'm sure you'll agree that there's a real and deep and worrying concern in relation to the alleged data breach at Independent News and Media that's been well reported on over the last number of weeks. Now, an independent and free media, we agree, is essential to the operation of a parliamentary democracy, and in particular the protection of journalistic sources, editorial independence, and indeed the independence of journalists and their freedom from any undue interference is something that we should all hold dear. And I think recent events serve as a wake-up call for the Oireachtas, in my view, more generally, to consider legislation to deal with these issues on a number of fronts. And a lot of work has been done by interested bodies in relation to this, not least former Chief Justice John Murray, who did a very, very comprehensive report published last year and which has not been acted on in relation to the protection of journalistic sources, particularly from the state side, but says that they should be applicable generally in terms of protecting journalistic sources as something that's essential to our democracy. There was a very comprehensive report undertaken over 2 years ago by UNESCO in relation to the desirability and the necessity for a national law to be established that would deal with these issues. Incredibly, very much on the button in terms of what has transpired over the last 2 weeks, and specifically saying that we should have specific national legislation for source protection, with its legal foundation in the right to freedom of expression, including press freedom and to privacy. And that such legislation should recognise that source protection should extend to all acts of journalism and across all platforms, services and mediums, and that includes digital data and metadata. Affirms that state and corporate actors, including third-party intermediaries who capture journalistic data, must treat it confidentially. And that the law should shield acts of journalism from targeted surveillance, data retention and handover of material to confidential sources. It says that and recommends that arbitrary, unauthorised and willful violations of confidentiality of sources by third-party actors should be criminalised. And in addition, we have the media monitoring plurality in league with the EU Commission and the DCU. Very high risks in terms of ownership, transparency of ownership and in terms of editorial autonomy. And fourthly, I'd put it to you, Taoiseach, and I would ask you, will the government consider legislative across those three strands that I've identified? And will you reaffirm to the House, because I think something happened yesterday whereby an actor of the state, the director of the Office of Corporate Director of Enforcement, was essentially received correspondence that in the line of his duty, he may be personally held liable in respect of certain things. I think it's very important that the message goes out from the Oireachtas and from government that any actor of the state is indemnified and will not lose out personally in any way for conducting his duty on behalf of the taxpayer and on behalf of the state. I think it's very important that that reaffirmation should be given in respect of the ODC director today.
Thanks very much, Deputy, for raising this important question. And to answer yours, I think given recent revelations, yes, we are going to have to give consideration to legislation in this area to protect sources. I'm not aware of any legislation being drafted currently by government, and I haven't seen any legislation drafted by opposition in the form of private members' bills in the past 2 years. But perhaps time has certainly come for government to dust down those reports and give consideration to legislation in this area. I think having independent news and media is a cornerstone of our democracy. It is, after all, the fourth estate. And I believe journalists must be free to pursue stories that they want to pursue. Their sources should be protected, free from any unjust interference, external or internal. We need the plurality of voices in the media. We need to ensure that these voices are not drowned out or silenced. And we also need diversity and ownership. So I commend journalists who work to report on this story, including journalists at Independent News and Media, who haven't allowed their independence to be compromised. Reports of the data breaches represent a very significant threat to the freedom of our press. However, I think the way that the media has responded to this threat to date should reassure us that our press will not be silenced. Obviously, any alleged breach of personal data is a matter of concern, whether it relates to journalists or public citizens. And it's important to say that although this is now a matter before the courts, we need to respect that and bear in mind that in terms of our contributions. I know the Deputy has. The Office of the Director of Corporate Enforcement, the ODCE, which is a government office at the Department of Business, has now made an application to the High Court under Section 748 of the Companies Act 2014 to appoint inspectors to investigate the affairs of I&M. This is now an enforcement matter for the ODC. Section 949, subsection 3 of the Companies Act provides that the Director of Corporate Enforcement shall be independent in the performance of his statutory functions. That case commenced as of yesterday. In terms of indemnity, it is absolutely the case that any public servant who acts properly and acts in accordance with their mandate and doesn't breach any laws or ethical principles is, of course, indemnified by the state.
Deputy Martin, you have 1 minute.
Thank the Deputy, Taoiseach, for his reply. And to say, Taoiseach, that Chief Justice Murray would have published his report, very comprehensive report, about a year ago, and I'm not aware if any action by the Line Minister has been taken on foot of that report, which deals with the whole issue of protecting journalistic sources. And secondly, the media, the Centre for Media Pluralism and Media Freedom and its monitoring of media freedom in Ireland, some yardsticks, some criteria, very high risk in terms of editorial autonomy, in terms of ownership and in terms of transparency around ownership, mainly due to the lack of any upper thresholds in terms of ownership. And I do put it to you that that does require review and consideration by the Oireachtas in general. I think the need now for law around protection of journalistic sources is imminent. I don't think it's something we can, given what has happened, hang around too long in relation to, because it is very fundamental to our democracy. And finally, I welcome your comments in relation to the Director of the Office of the Director of Corporate Enforcement. There has been no evidence at all to date, transparently, please, that they leaked anything. And I don't think any agent of the state should really have to work
under
that,
but the time
sort
is
of
up.
Intimidatory cloud hanging
Deputy,
over him in terms
Deputy,
of the conduct of his work.
Sorry,
apologies.
The time is up. I'm sorry.
I have only a few seconds.
No, it's 30 seconds, Deputy.
Thank you.
Yeah, certainly I can give a commitment to the Deputy that I'll speak to the Minister for Communications with a view to giving consideration to legislation in this area. And I think as well it might be something that the Joint Directors Committee on Communications could also give consideration to.